Welcome back, guys. I have got so much to tell you about that I barely know where to begin. Where am I going to start? I'm going to start by telling you that I'm going to start mixing the episodes up because when you start to see some of the stuff that I've discovered, you'll see that this is going to take so long. This is going to be a project that's going to take me, I don't know, like weeks to do, to completely finish. And I really want to do it. And you'll see why it's going to be so time consuming, but I think you'll think it's worth it. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to start mixing the episodes up, and I'll do a bit of stuff here, but I'm also going to be doing stuff elsewhere. So let's jump in. Okay, first of all, I did a bit of work down here. And this was really just to get like a screenshot for the last episode. So I just did this bit, right? And you can see I've kind of extended this a little bit and put the roads in and did a bit of texturing and threw some stuff in. But okay, first thing. Thank you to the person who pointed out that in these new buildings that I've got. I didn't see this, and it was the first time I'd used them. So if we go down to like these, but in fact, if I choose, is it those ones? No, it's it's not that one. It's these ones. These buildings, so like this warehouse. I thought it was just this warehouse. Oh no, there are four different versions of this warehouse over here. I never look at this. I just expected to say like no parameters, because like on everything else. Let's see, like all this stuff, it just has no parameters, there's never any options. So anyway, do you want to see the other ones? So we've got that one, then we've got this one, which is just like a little one, which is very cool. I can imagine all kinds of uses for that. And then this one, and that one's awesome. And I tell you what, I've left like a little space here, which is just blooming perfect for putting one of these in. So we spin it around. Get it lined up and plop it there. Oh my god. And this becomes like the most awesome modular warehouse. And there's also this one, which is slightly different to the existing one that we've got. So yeah, oh my god, that opens up some options. I've been doing some road work and putting some various roads around the place, and I put this extra bridge in. So we've got this one down here. I'm going to take that out and redo it, but we're going to have this one across here, which I think looks fantastic. And I spent a bit of time getting that nice and flat. Look at that. And if you really want to know how to get a nice flat bridge like this, I guess I'll show you when I redo that one. And you know what? Let me do this bit first, because I spent, I don't know, 4 or 5 hours last night playing around with this, with all the different models and all the rest of it. I'll just show you just before I do this. I'll just show you though. If you look at this stuff. So this stuff that I was throwing in here. Oh my god. All the options you've got, like for example, containers. There isn't just this one. Oh no, there's 5 different ones. There's that little one. There's this one, and this, and this. And you're probably thinking, yeah, but you want different colours and stuff. Well, ha, over here, these high ones. There's that one. These are all different colours. That one and that one and that one with a logo on the side. And that one, and then if you go into now, I've got to remember which one it is. I think it's is it the bulk goods? Is it the bulk goods? I don't know. I can't remember. That's this stuff. This is awesome. I love these little skips and great big skips full of different coloured materials. Oh, it's awesome. But one of these, actually, livestock has got some kind of containerish looking built things. That's pretty containerish, and that one, and that kind of sorta. But is it goods? I don't know. Here we go. Yeah, it's goods. So yeah, we've got a bunch of different goods. So there's the one with the logo. Oh, that's a pile of stuff. There's that one and that one. Oh, so there's tons. So I'm going to be playing around with that, and it's the same for everything else. There's just millions of options. So oh my god. And like, okay, this building over here, I've got to show you. See, I told you, I don't know where to start. There's so much to show you. That building, and I thought there was just one. Let's see. It's this one. Yeah. So I thought there was just that one. No. Like, there are two building types, and then there's five different versions. So like, you've got that, but you've also got that tiny one, right? And then you've got that one, which is, I love that. I think that's really nice. I can imagine using that quite a lot. But you know, each one has different variants. Look at, I mean, just freaking loads of options. It's incredible. So yeah, I'm sure we'll be playing around with that quite a lot. Definitely that one. Right. Let's actually build something. Shut up, Sky. Build something. I've got so much to freaking do. It's crazy. What I'm going to do, I'm going to take this, large country road. I'm going to extend this down here like that. Right. And then, now we want this kind of, I'm going to put some ramps in. I figured out how to do it. But what I'm going to do, I'm going to take this and I'm going to curve it round. Now, what I want is something that gives me, stop it. I hate it when it does it. It clicks when I'm trying to turn the screen. I should use the keys. It's me on fault. What I want is something that gives me kind of like a bit of a half circle. But I also... Oh, stop it. God damn it. But it's kind of... there we go. So I want something that doesn't kind of impact on this so that we can still see that. But I want to be able to come down to this road, but it needs to kind of like look right. So this can't be too steep. I think it, yeah, I don't know. Is that, I think that might be good enough. Yeah. Well, I think we'll take that. I don't know. It's not quite 90 degrees. I don't know. I think it is. So, all right, let's run that across into there. And then this, you kind of naturally think maybe that should run down there. So, I don't know, like bring it up here. And then that, it starts to define little areas. And I'm thinking, actually, now that area wants to be a little bit bigger. So, what about if we ran it up from there? Yeah, kind of liking that. And then we can put some stuff in here. All right, so let's pop that in. We want to take this back a little bit. Probably, I don't know, about there. So let's chop that off. And whoops, and then hook this up. Oh, and it needs to go back a little bit more, really. I don't know. Can I live with that? No, not really. Yeah, it's got to go back a little bit more. Let's chop a little bit more off. Boom, and that, and oh, let's see. How's that? Yeah, that's better. Yeah, I can live with that. Right. And then we'll take a medium road. And let's see. If I run a medium road, kind of up there. Yeah, maybe come back a fraction. Yeah, like that. And maybe run it down there and then hook it up to there. And then we kind of define these areas and then you can kind of figure out, well, hang on, so what should go in here? You see what I mean? So I have been playing around, putting some roads around the place. There's a lot more road work to do. What else? Okay, right. Let's do the cool thing. We're going to get trains out here. So, let's go over here. Let's get a train on the tracks. And we'll put a train onto somewhere over here. On one of these four tracks over here. So, we will take... Let me start from scratch. Because I was practicing with this. So, this is the fake loco. Right, and this costs nothing to buy, nothing to run, which means you can leave it out on the tracks and it doesn't cost you anything. But it has a top speed of 6 miles an hour. This thing is not quick. So we buy one of those, right? Now I've got a whole bunch of new wagons and stuff, new wagons and tankers and all kinds of lots of different colours and designs and all this kind of stuff, which will make our yard nice and colourful, which is exactly what we want. And let's see, I also got a mod which creates fake versions of some of the wagon types. So we've got like a fake goods wagon and a fake boxcar, and those don't cost anything. But these other ones, like all of these, they're actually going to cost money if we park them out on the track. So, but, you know, it is what it is. Now, the section of track that we're going to park on is about 650 metres long, 650, 700 metres long. So we want a nice, big, long train to go on there. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to start it off with a few boxcars, I think. So I'm going to throw in like one of those and one of those, one of those. Maybe one of these hoppers. These are really nice, by the way, this model. I like that. One of those. Maybe one of those as well. And then with the rest of the train is going to be tankers. So where will we start? Let's start off with one of those. And then it's just a case of like throwing these on until we get up to the length of train that we want. So I'm just going to kind of throw all of these on in order first. We can throw, let's use a fake one where we can. One of those, one of those. And then we'll start picking them at random. So one of those DHLs, one of those. One of those, green one, one of those, one of those, yeah, one of those, one of those, one of those again, another one of those. What are we up to? 474, still way to go. One of those, another green one, another blue one, another one of those, another one of those, one of these. What are we up to? 65, 76. I want to take this up to about 650 meters. So another one of those, that one, that one, 620. Let's have another one of those white ones, a blue one. That's 650. Yeah, that's fine. I think we'll stick with around 650 for this bit of track. Okay, right, now having got that train, we've somehow got to get it out on the track, right? So what we do is we go down here and we get a new line, and I'm going to make this yellow, bright yellow, so we can see it very clearly. Right, I'm going to put a couple of stations on here. Right, now this leads me to something else, but we'll talk about that in a minute. Let me turn all the icons off. Let me turn all the icons off except that. I need to get all of these stupid icons out of here. Right, so what I'm going to do, I'm going to put in Sparksville at one end, and I'm going to put in Troy at the other end. Actually, I'm going to put Troy in first, because I want it going that direction, and then we'll put that in first. So, remove. Okay. And then the track that I want to go onto, let's put it onto this track here. All right. So, like anywhere on this bit of track, we throw in a waypoint. And I got other stuff to show you. I've got so much to show you. It's insane. Let's throw in a waypoint there. Okay, so now what I'm going to do is add that waypoint in so that we move this route over to this track. And we'll do it for both directions. Not that we really need to, but just to be nice and tidy. Right, so now we can put this train onto line 14. Cha-ching. Right. Off we go. Here it is. Right. Let's crank it up. And you'll see that this will start to move very, very, very freaking slowly. Because it's got a top speed of like, what was it, 6-7 miles an hour? Right. Let's turn off the ad stations. Let's click on this. So here it comes. Now, obviously, to get that down there, because it's got like quite a long way to go to get down here. It'll take a while. So let's speed things up. But it is staggeringly staggering. Wait till you see what this looks like once you've actually got it out there. Oh, we've got an autosave going on. Now, while that's getting there, oh, all those icons have disappeared. Hooray! That's good news. Awesome. Oh, another thing I can do while that's doing that, I am kind of finally decided on, but what I was thinking of doing was upgrading some of the tracks to high speed tracks, like the kind of the main routes, not the actual sidings, right, but kind of the main routes. So like, if I zoom out, so like that there, and that there. Up to that point, because the thing is, these tracks in the sidings tend to get really rusty and whatever because they're not used. They haven't got trains going over them all the time to polish them. Whereas these kind of main routes would be more polished because they've got trains going over them, like fairly frequently. And I've been looking at this and thinking, I need to do a tiny adjustment on here, which is if I just take that back a tiny bit and run that into, oh, wrong one. I did it wrong again, into there. Actually, these need to be the same length when I do this. There we go. If I run that into there, and then take that up to there. Oh! That track, like, pause, because that's the end of the train coming out there. Right, so, and then we'll hook that up to, come on, there we go. Being a bit laggy at the moment, like for a change, and hook that up to there. There we go, right. So this train, look at the freaking size of that train. It's awesome, isn't it? Right, keep going, train. Come on. Needs to come down to, like, pretty much down to this waypoint, kind of probably just before this waypoint would be just where we want it. And you can see that the locomotive is actually invisible, completely invisible. Right, here we go. Almost there, and that, I think, is where we want it. So, we now tell it to stop. There we go. It stopped. And now we have a train. So let's get rid of line 14. We will be reusing that. But look. Look. Instantly, you can kind of see when we've got, like, loads of these in. Oh, my God. Now, that's one thing that's going to make our train yard look awesome. I've said this before, but I still keep getting comments about it. I am going to have stuff moving around, right? And we've got this oil well here. We've got a refinery up there. We've got another refinery over here. And I would like to get, like, stuff being moved around, but I'm not quite sure how I'm going to do it yet. I've been kind of thinking about it, but I haven't really decided exactly how I'm going to do it yet. But we'll get to that. Now you know how we run the trains out, and you know how they look, and they do look just spectacular, I think. But we're now going to get on to the next thing, which is the some of the terrain textures, and I wanted to play around with this little area in here and kind of show you what you can do with the textures, because once you play around with them, you can actually do some pretty freaking incredible things. So I want custom. Here we go. Right. So this is one of the things that's just gonna take ages. It just is. You know, it's just one of those things. Get over it, accept it. It's gonna take freaking forever to do this. What I'm gonna do is lay down some asphalt, right? And I'm deliberately leaving kind of little patches in between. And you'll see why I'm doing that. not big patches, but just kind of little patches where the grass is just kind of showing through a bit. Now I need to do, because I've got an idea for a bit of a design. I was actually playing around with this. this is where a lot of the 4 hours, it's 5 hours. A lot of the 5 hours last night went, was when I started playing around with this terrain stuff, and then I just got totally carried away. And you'll see why. It's just staggering what you can do. I mean, you want to exercise your your creative muscles? Oh my God, this is the way to do it. It's a shame that you can't kind of paint these, but the thing is, if you could paint them, you wouldn't be able to do, potentially, what I'm going to show you. And what I'm going to show you, I think is kind of sweet. I think you will be surprised, and I think you'll be delighted. So, let's bang a little bit more. But you want it to be, like, fairly random-ish to get like the best effects. Let's leave that. There's a lot to do. How far down am I going to go? Yeah, I don't know. We'll see. You know what? I think I'll probably do this whole little section here now. Now, the thing is, these textures I found overlay in a very specific order. Okay. So, for example, this brown earth overlays tarmac, right? So, if I put that there, you just get a complete splodge, right? Which doesn't kind of work. But if you put down this gravel, it goes underneath like that. Okay, so we can put a bunch of this in to create like a different texture effect, and depending on how much of a gap you leave, you get like different effects. So we do this one like this. Yeah, I swear you're gonna love this. But like I said, it does kind of take a while. And when I think about, see, the thing is, I'm doing this, right? That's like one little area. Okay, where's the fairly big view? But when you look at the whole thing, oh my God, that's why this is gonna take a long freaking time. Let's bang in some more around. Do. And a bit up there. Do. Bit down there. There we go. Yeah, seriously, you can actually spend a lot of time getting a really, really nice effect, and you can kind of go so. Right, you get that, right? But even that's kind of okay. But now the thing is, if you put this on, this just plops right on the top, and the same with this one. So for like, okay, so that just overwrites everything. This one is the same, and it actually overwrites the brown, right? So we're not going to use those two. Well, actually, we are going to use those two. We're just not going to use them in the middle. So for example, by the sides of the tracks, we could put in some little kind of nasty brown marks, right? And depending on how far out you put it, you can get different amounts of little marks. And let's have one in there, and one there. Let's have a couple together, and let's make this a kind of a dirty corner. Down there, and a little bit up here, just a little bit there. There, like that, and tiny patches there. So yeah, you can have all kinds of fun, like decorating the edges. Oh, and of course you could use this one as well. So you've got the dark, but you can also throw in this, and of course it overwrites the brown, so then you can get like multiple layered textures. And there's also this one, this also overlays these, so this is yet another texture that you can kind of throw in at the sides to give kind of different effects and kind of blend this all in and get some pretty nice effects. And then this was the one that really surprised me, the white. You can use this as kind of a highlight, so let's throw the white in there. Oh, look at that. And it sits underneath these, so you can just get these kind of little patches. Now over here there's some big kind of big, right, if you put that in there, right, now you may look at that and go, ooh, that's a bit too much. Well, if it's a bit too much, then we can cover up some of it with a bit of that, add a bit more asphalt maybe, just to tone it down a little bit, until you get like exactly the effect you're looking for. It's staggering, isn't it, guys? Come on, be fair. Be fair, this is pretty freaking awesome. There we go, a little bit there. I mean, this is custom blooming, custom textures. Let's tone that down. There we go, and maybe, actually, no, it's probably okay, actually. Maybe want a tiny little bit somewhere down here. Let's pop it up here, might be good enough. Might be good enough. Let's throw some of that in there. Let's throw a bit more gravel around the place. Throw a bit more gravel there. Tone that down a little bit. There we go. What do you think? You like it? And the same applies. Now that's bad enough doing that, right? And I'm going to have to do all of these kind of big areas. That's bad enough. It's when you start doing the in between the tracks. Now, primarily in between the tracks, we're going to be using this this grass, right? But we're also going to be using the dirt, and we'll probably be using some of the gravel as well. So, and it's a case of, you know, trying to create something that kind of looks realistic, but there's so many different effects that you can kind of throw into this. So you can just get little bits of spills and stuff. And throw some of this in, yeah, maybe there. And then this is the one that kind of sits on the top. So if you want to turn some stuff down, this is the only one that, this is actually the top level, this one. So. And again, you could do the same thing. So you could put them, instead of putting them in, put them off to the side and create, you know, different effects. And same with this one, you just have a little patches kind of sticking out into the thing, and you can create awesome effects. But you can see I've just done that kind of little bit there, and I haven't even finished it. Look how much there is to do, right? So that's going to take hours. That's going to be hours of me just sitting here kind of handcrafting these. But when you combine this with this, oh man, you get awesome things. Now let's go back to this area, because this is where things get really cool. As if that wasn't cool enough. I'm going to take a small country road now. I started playing around with an idea last night. So, I'm going to run a road. Yeah. let's run it up like about like that maybe. Right, and then okay, let's begin the coolness. Oh come on, work. You worked last night. Oh come on, what the hell's wrong with you? Oh here we go. Oh. Right, to about there. Can I get a bit further? Ah, here we go. To about... actually, a bit further back. I think about there. Okay. Then bring it out and hook it up like this. Huh. And you can create all kinds of little effects. And if we go up to there... And... Oh, come on. And... Oh. And do the same thing on the other side. And it's kind of about getting it to come out at, like, the right angle and stuff to give you the right kind of thing. I think something like that might work. Bring that down to there. Like, how cool's that? And you're probably thinking, what the hell is that? That's not cool, that's just stupid. Hang on a second, no, we haven't finished yet. We'll extend that up there, like that. There. And then I'm actually going to take this track out. And I'm going to have a road running up there. Make sure that I get the bit underneath. Boom. Oh, which one was I deleting? This one. Here we go. And once we've taken all of that out, road in. Yeah, that's good. Zip down here. Put the road in between these, like that. Oh, like it. And then hook that up to there. Cha-ching. Oh, yeah. Then we go to our decorations. So let's see. Let's get my goods. So what do we want in here? Oh, what don't we want in here? You know what? Let's start off with some bulk materials. Where's bulk materials? That's livestock, steel, boxes, containers. Where the hell's bulk goods? That's goods. Oh, here we go. Bulk goods. let's get some of this going. I think we'll have containers over here. We'll have bulk goods over here. So, boom, 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 boom. Right. And then we take another type. This one's quite bright. This is kind of the brightest one. So I'm going to be kind of sparing with this one. We might have many of these in it, I don't think. One down there. And yeah, let's put that one there. Okay. And then this is kind of a brownish color. Bang some of these in around the place. Couple in there. Next one on the end. Couple on that end. And then finally, fill in with this one. So, boom, boom. Now, let's see. Let's mix it up a little bit. Variety, and let's have some iron. And let's see, what's this? This is, I guess this is coal. Boom, boom, boom. And let's see, what's this? This is, oh, I guess this is slag. Yeah, I'm thinking this is slag. So let's pop some of those in. Alrighty. Oh, I like it. I like it. And then we kind of want to make the ends a little bit untidy. How about some goods? Let's get some. Now, that's the container, but one of these is. Yeah, here we go. Nice pile of boxes. Let's have a nice pile of boxes. Let's flip you around. And put you in there. And then there's a little pile of boxes somewhere. Where's the. Well, oh, I didn't mean to put that there. Don't. Get rid of you. Where's my little pile of boxes? No. There's a really nice little pile of boxes somewhere. I don't know where it is. Yeah, that's a container. No. Is it this way? One of these has got a really nice little. Oh, here we go. Boxes. Yeah, there we go. That's the one I was looking for. Yeah, I'll flip that around a little bit so it's oriented differently. And. Yeah, maybe. A couple of different boxes like that lying around. There we go! Starting to get somewhere, maybe? Let's extend that road. Go down like. God knows what I'm going to do with this. Like, seriously, I have no idea. I mean, I could like make another little circly thing if I wanted to at this end, which is kind of maybe an idea actually. Come on. Yeah, too much curvature. Yeah, I'm not going to play around in it now. I'll sort that out another time. What else do we want? We want some more stuff around the place. Let's get some containers, shall we? So let's see. I want goods. So let's have some containers going in. So do. Now, where do I want these? Kind of. Let's have. Boom. And. That's a couple of those, I guess. Kind of together, and right, let's get. Oh, those are the boxes. Now we want some of these. Couple of those together, and we'll throw some of these grey ones in. Kind of generic ones as well. As well as, if I go to the, where's the livestock? Where's the livestock? Because we've got different ones in the livestock as well. Livestock, here we go. So there's so many different models to choose from. And that one's that weird one. Yeah. I think I'll use that one for something else. And then let's go back to this. I'm going to put one of these on the end. Then we'll get some high ones. And we'll put some high ones in to kind of mix things up a little bit. Grey ones together. That's a logo one. That's a brown one on the top of there. We'll take a logo one on there. Oh, the fun you can have. It's kind of insane. And that's about, yeah, so another logo one on there. And logo, and a brown one, and maybe a couple of grey ones. Where's the grey one? There's the grey one. Let's have a great one on there. Great one on there. Great one on there. I'm looking at that one thinking, I really need to replace that. And I think we need another white one, just to light things up a little bit. Alrighty, are we kind of getting somewhere? But I think you can see, it takes a hell of a long time. But I think it's worth it, don't you? I mean, I seriously think it's worth it. And then we could, I don't know, there's also the steel. Where should we do some steel? Should we do some steel down here? Let's do some steel down here. So we've got different types. We've got some big piles of steel. We've got some kind of long, small bits. So I think what we'll do, let's flip you around that way. Let's have some of you. And then flip you around this way. And have some of you stacked up here. Like that. And then we'll have the big stacks, I think. Oh, those are those little, oh yeah, those are those little ones. That's a really nice, those are. That's that one. But here's the big stack. There's the big stack. Right, let's have some big stacks. A couple of big stacks like that, maybe? Or do we want it that way? You know what? Let's put them like that. Yeah, I like it. And then we'll finish off. Where's the other one? Oh, these. We'll finish off with some of these. So. Boom, boom, boom. Okay. What do we think, guys? Are we heading in the right direction? I freaking think we are. And then, of course, once you've done that, you can then, if you want, go back to the textures and add some kind of mucky marks and stuff. It's a bit like, not the road, guys. Let's make it a bit kind of dirtier along there. Put some more dirt under these. Like that. I could probably do the same thing over here. Maybe there. Just darken the area underneath. Let's have a little bit of muck in front of those. Yeah, maybe. There we go. All right, but you can see, you know, I mean, the amount of hand crafting that goes into this is pretty extreme. Let's have a little bit of that there. Oh, that one sits under that one. There then. And yeah, so yeah. I mean, the long and the short of it is, you can spend absolutely freaking hours like decorating this stuff and making it like more and more realistic and textured and all of that kind of stuff. And the more you do it, I mean, the better it gets. But it takes huge amount of time. Right. So, now, I need to run more trains out here. But you saw how long it takes. So I think that's probably best, maybe a few in time lapse. But I think probably a lot of that needs to be done kind of like offline. And then I just show you afterwards. What else? Oh, yeah. I remember. Now, this was an idea that I had. And I'm not 100%, but I don't know. We'll see. I wanted to show you this anyway. I picked up a new railway station, and this thing is It's seriously awesome. This is, if I get on a bit that doesn't come up with that. This is Bandian's Dusseldorf railway station. And this is very different. You will not have seen a station like this because this has got variable platform lengths. Now, it's up to a 16-track station. Let's drop it down to like, six. Now, you can have different, like, actually, let's make it 8. It's kind of more interesting. Right, now you can have all kinds of configurations with this. I'm actually going to drop the length down. It's very slow, it's very laggy trying to put this down. Where can I kind of throw this in? You know what I was thinking of doing, okay, was to have kind of like an entry. I actually want it round the other way. Like that kind of thing. And I was thinking of having this as like an entrance to the yard on like both sides. And I really, like, the more I think about it, the more I really like that idea. So, you know what? Let's do something. So let's get rid of this bit of track in here. And we'll probably have to take this bit out as well to get this in. Boom. That'll do. I think that'll do. Okay. And then, now let's see. How many? I've got 8 tracks on there. How do I want to orient this? Okay. I think what we'll do, take this back a little bit more. I think this is going to kind of create like an interesting entrance to the place, and it gives us more options for doing things, which will, like, I don't even know how to explain it, like the ideas that I've got for this. So, if we put it, I don't know, see, that's too far. We could probably kind of want it in maybe that kind of alignment. Yeah, I'm thinking maybe a little bit there. Kind of thing. Let's bring those out like this. And then we can just like hook these up to these ones. Like that. And like. Oh, come on. There we go. And like that. So we've got this entrance. And what I love about this has got kind of a fairly, I don't know, it's kind of a, I don't know, a fairly industrial kind of look to it. Because it's just these very basic square, blocky brick buildings. It's not flash, it's not modern looking in any way. I kind of like that. So yeah, I was thinking of like maybe having that at least one end. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to kind of throw it in for now and kind of see how I think at this point. I'll try and jam some time lapse in at the end of the video. There was a lot to show you, a lot to talk about. So yeah, shut up, Sky, you're wasting time. Cue the time lapse. We'll be right back. Okay, well, we're going to have to leave it there for this episode. Let's have a little bit of a quick look around. So, loving this little area here. I just love this. Still needs, like a couple of little things. Now, one thing that I do have that I can show you very quickly is, if I can find the damn thing, somewhere in here. Oh, here we go. I do actually have a mod that allows you to put trucks down. Now, if I go to this, there's all kinds of options. If we go to the 40 ton, so I could like park a truck here or something. The thing is, there's really only the 40 ton truck that's usable. I mean, I suppose you could maybe use the man, but really we need a mod that with some better trucks. I have got some extra trucks to have running around the place, which we will have. I'll talk to you more about that in one sec. Let's just show you quickly. So I've now picked up a whole bunch of different Volvos that we can use, which are like give us some real variation. And this Cam A3, which is pretty nice. So we'll definitely have some of that stuff running around. And this is one of the reasons that I'm putting in like lots of depots. And there's going to be lots of depots all over the place. And I'm going to have some trucks running around. But also, like over here, we've got this this oil depot. Which, what do you think? I'm actually fairly pleased about that. I may make a few changes. I'm not absolutely convinced about these like that, but we'll see. I might make a few changes, but like generally speaking, pretty damn pleased with that. Love this whole thing, but it's like we've got to get the oil from here up to this thing, and what I don't want is just like a constant stream of lorries running around. But maybe if we can get them going to different depots and going like different routes and stuff like that, then maybe, I don't know, maybe we can make it work somehow. So yeah, that's the general idea there. These trains, obviously, I mean, I think they look absolutely fantastic. We've got tons and tons of work to do. We need trains going backwards and forwards. Putting this in, I'm probably going to put like one or two like single track, single platform stations, freight stations around the place and have trains going hither and thither. Just single locomotives, maybe some short trains, maybe like one or two big long trains. I don't know. We'll see. There's more buildings to go in. I've got to do a whole thing with this back area and put in like a forest. And there's going to be trees around here. I've got to sort out the roads. There's a million things to do. It's freaking awesome. I love it. You know what? Let's just turn it on for the last few seconds. See the trains running by. Oh, I think it's going to be awesome. But next episode, we're going to be kind of back to usual. I'll be doing adding more production lines. Hopefully, we'll be getting some of the more complex things. We'll get some goods running. We'll get some food coming in down here, that kind of stuff. I need to lie down. I'll catch you later. Peace out.